Now you have the sins of the common people here. That is Joe Doakes and John Doe, by the way. And that's you and I. We're talking about common people now. Verse 27. And if any of the common people sin through ignorance, while he doeth somewhat against any of the commandments of the Lord concerning things which ought not to be done and be guilty. We're talking about common people, talking about you, talking about me. And the offering was for a sin through ignorance. And it was against the commandment of God. And that is something specifically stated as being forbidden. And it has to be established again that he's guilty, that this is not just hearsay. Now, this offering was to lift the guilt complex and to satisfy the conscience. You see, again, friends, the death of Christ alone can lift the crushing guilt complex from modern man. Psychological procedures have not been able to accomplish this. The conscience may be seared with a hot iron, and you may transfer the guilt complex from one area to another. But down deep in the human heart, there is this strange guilt complex that lingers on and on and on, and it's only as you bring it to Christ. Now we're told here, verse 28, or if his sin, which he hath sinned, come to his knowledge, then he shall bring his offering, a kid of the goats, a female without blemish, for his sin which he hath sinned. Now, something may come to his knowledge later, and it's no longer a sin through ignorance, but it requires the same sacrifice. And today, what does the believer do? Well, we go to Christ as a lost sinner, and we accept him as Savior. And then as believers, we find out that we sin. So what do? If we confess our sins, he's faithful and just to forgive us our sins, cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Now, it's a kid of the goats, a female. Now, you see again, the offering is of less value than any previous offering for any group. The offering was required, but all point to the death of Christ. Now, the ritual here again is the same as it was for the others, because all has to be put on the basis of the death of Christ. Now, that brings us down here in this final clause of this chapter, and it shall be forgiven him. Do you note that? It shall be forgiven him. That's an important truth. And complete forgiveness was secured for the sinner. Total absolution was accomplished when Christ died, in whom we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of sins according to the riches of his grace.